couple of the things that the government is going to, if we have to train cadets in the proper way, we find that it's going to be public private driven.
About 32 years ago, myself and a lot of my colleagues who came through that system found ourselves in exactly the same shoes as those young chaps who have recently departed from Malaysia. At that time, of course, it was necessary.
Possibilities of a fulfilling career at sea.
Before now, they used to march into a life of uncertainty and no hope. But now, with a memorandum of understanding signed with Malaysia on cadet training, these graduates of Maritime Academy of Nigeria, Oron, face an exciting career at sea as sailors in training. Since the onset of Obasanjo's second coming to power, things are looking up for the Maritime Academy of Nigeria. The President, two transport ministers and the NMA chief executive went to the support of successive rectors of the Academy with an apparent new zeal.
Aye, sir.
When the President visited in 1999, he promised both infrastructure and more money.
I believe that my visit today will make me know what should be done about your academy. An academy must be a scene of pride, particularly a naval or maritime academy.
On his part, Chief Ojo Maduekwe, as transport minister, demanded results. But his successor at Bukka Dipcharibe House since 2003 went further to cement foreign assistance through the Memorandum of Understanding with the Malaysians.
The ministry will be committed to giving you all the support you ensure. We lift this institution to where it should be, the foremost maritime institution in the world.
It required the day-to-day coordination of the National Maritime Authority, however, to see that the sea time programs for graduating cadets were restarted, despite the lack of local fleet. And this took some 3 years of managing the bureaucracy in Nigeria and shuttling to meetings with the Malaysian ship-owning consortium.
One of the easiest areas for us to participate is, of course, in providing crew for the vessels that operate in our domestic space.
Yes.
And it will be sad if we allow a situation to continue that we don't have qualified crew to take advantage of the opportunities inherent in our domestic space. So I think that it's a good step forward.
The Maritime Academy of Nigeria, Oron, in Akwa Ibom State, started in 1978 following encouragement by maritime operators and an expatriate government inspector of shipping. The vision was a training ground for future Nigerian master mariners, engineers, and ship managers for a country that boasts of over 800 kilometers of ocean shoreline.
The last colonial government inspector of shipping, Captain Agu, was instrumental to articulating the reason for the establishment of the port congestion, the requirements of the NNSL, and also at the time the palm lines, the Erdem style, and I think the gunboats, among others, had made very serious demands on Nigerian seafarers, not just as sailors, cooks, stewards, and greasers, but for the first time, Nigerian merchant navy officers, were already holding the mark. But most of them were trained abroad.
By the 1980s, the Nigerian National Shipping Line commanded a healthy position in the sea trade between Nigeria and many of her trading partners, especially Great Britain and the rest of Europe. The training of Nigerian cadets for the basics of seafaring usually began in Nigerian and Ghanaian nautical schools of various categories, but the finishing stages were mainly at English schools. This was the case for the first and second generation of Nigerian sailors and master mariners who were trained by Nigerian Ports Authority at huge costs of foreign exchange. The Maritime Academy of Nigeria at Oron was meant to address this problem, since foreign exchange was becoming scarcer and Nigerians who could teach the younger generation of prospective seafarers were now back in the country.
We're taking amperage for the ship, we're taking voltages, we're taking resistance for the ship.
Here we have open hand corners. These corners are being produced by cadets, the HMB project. And it has it's a model of this, and they improve on it.
Maritime Academy of Nigeria, Oron, began as a nautical college in 1978 with an enabling decree which stipulates that training of seafarers was the major focus. The first rector, Ime Ntiandem, a master mariner, was told to raise a school that will outshine similar institutions around Africa.
It was obligated for us to be able to build up a very good faculty. I was able to pay my good lecturers in dollars, wasn't in Naira. So I had a good chief technical advisor from IM. I was able to get about four experts.
Nigeria's desire to develop more indigenous seafarer population had to do with the economic demands of access to her emerging commercial prospects, including the oil and gas energy sectors, which have to do with oceans, rivers, and lagoons. By the 1940s, when political independence loomed the horizon, Nigeria's economy was yet to have many bridges across many of these water bodies. Before the construction of the present River Niger Bridge at Onitsha, for example, the huge traffic between Asaba and the Onitsha main markets and other outlying parts of Igbo land had to make do with ferries and pontoons. All along the trading centers from Baru through Lokoja, Makurdi, and to the riverine areas of the Niger Delta, an impressive flotilla made up of local and foreign-built watercraft facilitated travel. In Lagos at this time, it was estimated that nearly 10,000 dock workers employed by the Marines Department, the precursors of the present-day NPA, had to be ferried daily across the Lagos Lagoon from Apapa to Marina. The demand was so much for the watercraft as it was for sailors, pilots, deckhands, marine engineers, and ratings. In Nigeria, during the 1950s, the Marines employed and trained seafarers for the home trade certificates, which qualified them for local and coastal navigation.
Oh, MPA can, you know, you see, you are looking at MPA like the old MPA. MPA is still strange.
Yes, but they have to now refocus.
You know, every FPA trains, you know. I mean, majority of the master mariners today
were trained.
They were all MPA trained. Forget whether they return back there or not, you know.
But presently?
Presently, they are still training.
Okay.
They are still training because some people still have to man. I mean, upper master, basic qualification is master mariner.
After the first and second generations of seafarers were trained overseas, the 1970s ushered in new thinking on the matter of further training. The establishment of the Nautical College at Oron by a decree during the military regime of General Obasanjo in 1978 became the beginning of a shift in focus for accelerated manpower development for the expanding Nigerian sea trade. The school opened with the departments of Nautical Science, Marine Engineering, and Marine Business Studies. Other departments like boat and shipbuilding have been added, as well as various mandatory and remedial short courses. In 1994, the Federal Ministry of Transport mandated some of its parastatals to construct different academic and administrative buildings for the college, which was by now formally styled as Maritime Academy of Nigeria, Oron. These were the Nigerian Ports Authority, the National Maritime Authority, and the Nigerian Shippers Council. But the bulk of carrying the financial load of the academy's projects fell directly on the NMA because of mandates of its founding act.
The place of Nigeria on the white list was a very great achievement on the part of the present administration because, as you know, the white list had been in place for so many years before Nigeria was finally got in the last lap of the white list. With regards to the Maritime Academy of Nigeria, Oron, that is the only college that was submitted as the training institution for Nigeria to the IMO when we were submitting the white list proposal. Being that as it may, it now means that the academy will respond for the training of all the cadets that will come up for examinations with us. The academy will prepare the students for us, and then we will now examine them for a certificate of competence. That is the procedure. What they issue to them is academic certificates.
Yes.
We issue them with what we call professional certificates of competence. So that is the relationship between NMA and the Maritime Academy of Oron.
In the last few years, let me state categorically that the NMA, for the first time, is providing for the Nigerian maritime industry the kind of direction and leadership we have been craving for long. And I've been in this industry for the past 20 years, so I know what I'm talking about. Several administrations over the years, we train these cadets, they stop at the first phase of the training because there were no ships. And the best we could do was go from country to country, signing memorandum of understanding. But nothing came out of all this memorandum of understanding. But suddenly, on the sky, there was a silver lining, and that was the advent of the Malaysians.
The money NMA is spending now on the Sea Time program and the one it spent earlier in equipping the institution are geared for another critical relationship, and that is to prepare the institution as the recognized training school for Nigeria's whitelist accreditation at the International Maritime Organization. But not all of the academy's course curricula have to do with navigation and nautical sciences. It also teaches students of maritime business studies who are looking towards work in offices for shipping lines, ship agents, chandlers, and freight forwarders. Therefore, support base for the academy's development projects is widening by the day.
We have trained staff and are still training staff of Mobile Producing Nigeria, SPDC, Lamnaco, Intel, Stidex, so many, I cannot enumerate them. We are training staff for the core maritime establishments. We are training staff for shipping companies. we are training staff for the oil and gas industry. In fact, that is where our greatest patronage has been coming from the oil and gas industry.
At the departure ceremony for the 30 successful cadets in Lagos before their trip to Malaysia, the Transport Minister applauds such an MOU that will usher in a $2 million sea time training program for Nigerian cadets and pledge the resolve of the federal government to take more progressive action from now on.
As I look at your faces, I see hope. I see commitment. I see a greater Nigeria. I see a better Nigeria. I see a group of future leaders of our nation who are going to indeed take this nation's maritime industry to greater heights.
Mr. Ibrahim Hamdallah is the goodwill ambassador of the Malaysian International Shippers Corporation, who will conduct the cadets from Lagos to Kuala Lumpur to board their various ships.
This occasion marks another milestone towards strengthening relations between the two countries, Malaysia and Nigeria. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, bilateral relations between Malaysia and Nigeria has always remained cordial and friendly, but it lacks substance to further cement the ties which was established since 1960 when Nigeria gained her independence from the British.
The DG of NMA delivers an address to mark history. Today's occasion shows the fulfillment of a mandate which had eluded Nigeria in the past 14 years.
This for us is largely a day of thanksgiving and also a day of looking forward, because I believe that the program of capacity building for the Nigerian maritime industry has taken a major step forward. It is therefore my honor and privilege to thank so many people that have made it possible. Our first thank must of course go to His Excellency the President. It was his visit to Malaysia that opened this strategic window of opportunity.
The NMA, as the official counterpart sponsor of the program on the Nigerian side, arranged for all the financial costs and commitments needed to help the students gain this cherished time at sea, including air tickets, visa and hotel logistic costs to shipside. The tutelage will last for 12 months on board foreign-going vessels of the Malaysian International Shipping Corporation.
I think the most important question is, what is the overall cost implication
of the
program? Mm-hmm. In 1996, the Maritime Authority had attempted this type of program. We hired the vessels of a reputable Nigerian company called East West Coast Marine Services.
Yes.
Then it cost us $4,150 per day without VAT to train 30 cadets. And they were basically undertaking coastal and near coastal voyages. Nothing with the kind of international spread that the MISC can provide. And we had the cadets on board for a period of about 6 months. The entire program cost about $700,000.
Yeah.
If you were to prorate it at that day's cost, without quality of facility, what we have extracted from the Malaysian International Shipping Corporation is training worth about $3.2 million.
Okay.
Because the total arrangement is to train 60 cadets in batches of 30 over a 2 year period.
Okay.
So if you were to extrapolate it, if we are to benchmark against a program that, with all due respect, is not as qualitative as this, then you can say that the global cost, initial cost, is about $3.2 million. And because we are not paying it, that is the value of the savings. Now, in terms of direct costs, NMA basically is providing the flight tickets to and fro for all the batch of cadets. And we've given them some stipends for their initial settling down. The Malaysians will provide them with stipends, just like they would give to any other cadet or aboard their vessel.
All right.
So the cost, the direct cost to us is quite minimal.
Okay.
That is why we say that we are reaping the benefits of our nation's standing in the world.
It ought to be a continuous batch from their nautical science and marine engineering classrooms to finding places for sea time experience aboard suitable ships. Nigerian cadets have suffered such a denial of this career opportunity that these lucky few are overjoyed. Most expressed a higher feeling of patriotism towards their fatherland.
Basically, I have to thank the NMA, the federal government, the Ministry of Transport, especially the minister, towards this development. I think it's going to be a kind of help and success to us, because this has been one of the problems we have been facing.
I really thank NMA for this opportunity. I really feel very great to be a Nigerian now, because going to Malaysia, I think I'm going to fly the flag of Nigeria very high there.
Some of them have also wondered aloud what their fate will be after the 1 year hands-on training aboard trading vessels.
Now we have problems like at home now we don't have vessels.
Yeah.
Now they say we should be coming back after the 1 year.
Yeah.
Now we don't know our fate, if when we come back we are going to be employed by NMA or we are just going to be laid fallow there, wasting all the talents we have, skills and talents we have acquired from Malaysia.
Ideally, what should happen is that after the 12-month training, they will get back to the academy, complete their program, and do their certification exams. Outside that, the formal training virtually ends.
Okay.
Now, it's not so much a matter of NMA supporting them. The industry has a role for them as seamen. That was why this government passed the Cabotage Act.
Okay.
The moment they are certified, it virtually means that the vessels operating here would take them on board if they so wish. There is also the prospect, of course, that a couple of them may do reasonably well, and the Malaysians or whoever may need their services.
Yes.
Nigerian indigenous maritime operators are no less enthusiastic about the breakthrough for the cadets.
On the one hand, I'm glad that we have indeed found an outlet for the pent-up aspirations of cadets who have indeed gone through the college training.
Yes.
And have had good difficulties finding a berth, shipboard berth, to carry out their sea service training.
Yes, sir.
So I am really happy on the one hand that we have indeed found a berth for them. But on the other hand, I really think, I sincerely hope that it's a short-term solution.
Okay.
That in the long run, that we would indeed do the right and correct thing. And rather than sending our cadets to Malaysia to train, we would indeed provide the means for them to train on Nigerian ships.
Yeah.
I'd be very much interested to see the reports coming in.
Okay.
Because when you get reports coming in from Master and Malaysia government concerning the cadets, then it's going to reflect on our academy.
Yeah.
And it might help us to develop the academy to the standard. If not, you know, they are creating doubts.
For the NMA, however, it is another season of fulfillment that its increased basket of functions in the maritime regulatory portfolio is bringing more results. Yet, the public expectation is higher than ever.
You are aware that we are doing what we call the National Maritime Resource Development Center.
Okay.
That center, I hope, should be operational in the next 18 months.
Okay.
It's been built at Kirikiri Phase 2.
Yeah.
It has an auditorium, it has a large block for safety administration. Mm. We have a provision there for search and rescue services, a spillway for boat repair, but most importantly, a very ultra modern electronic library and classroom blocks.
Okay.
The logic of locating that resource center at Apapa is to create a place where industry operators can afford to release their staff to come and take modules of courses so that people can update their knowledge in terms of modern trends and developments in global shipping, even as they work.